playing his 52nd game of the season. That means he's played one more than he did last campaign. Some amount of football, even if you are a goalkeeper.
Absolutely, and you know, what an incredible comeback.
Yeah, McGregor, right hand side of the box here for Roberts as they attack the Motherwell end. It's Roberts cutting it back. First time effort is slapped towards goal by Rogic. Didn't get enough on it to trouble Conor Ripley. Kind of sliced it almost, and the keeper holds on comfortably enough. It is Celtic 0, Motherwell 0 here in Glasgow.
Yeah, Paddy Roberts did really well again on the right hand side, but picking out his pass, picking somebody out in the box, which is the difference between just knocking it in there. And it was a good ball. He had all the time in the world. I thought he actually even taken a touch, but he dug his shot down into the ground and straight at the goalkeeper.
Ball taken down on the far side by Johansson, moves it to the left for Tierney. It's blocked on the halfway line. Went Motherwell with it back just over on that far side. It's good work there by Luke Watt to win it back for Motherwell. His long ball forward as he kept it in play, preventing the throw-in, goes all the way through to Craig Gordon, who bowls it underarm to his left for Sviatchenko. The Danish international won his fifth cap for Denmark in the recent friendly against Scotland at Hampden. Across the city, across the river, as Rogic moves it into Armstrong. Lovely run, he's inside the box. Armstrong cuts it back! Good save by the foot there by Conor Ripley from Ryan Christie, who was so, so close to being in for his first Celtic goal. The goalkeeper keeps it out, 7.5 in, stays nothing each.
Yeah, it was a really good save with his feet, but it was brilliant play from Armstrong. Bursting forward with a bit of pace, taking on his stride, and then again picking out young Christie, and he could have been a hero. Playing up in a striker's role, but it was a brilliant save. Low down to his left hand to get his foot to it and just knocking it away. Anything does.
Ryan Christie's dad Charlie, of course, in a spell here as well early in his career. It's just in front of us in the director's box. Celtic collect with Armstrong. We're keen to end the season on a high. It hasn't been a vintage season for Stuart Armstrong. When he came here, he was just about part of the Scotland squad. There were raised eyebrows when he wasn't named in the Scotland squad at times last season. He got anywhere near those levels this campaign. Stepping your hands to play save another. Here comes Tierney, though, who had hit those levels. Cross ball comes in, Johnson misses it, and that missed there by Marvin Johnson. Out Fox Patrick Roberts, as Johnson is able to clear. Roberts was expecting the Motherwell left back today to get a touch on that. Motherwell are able to clear, and it's out for a throw-in midway inside their own half here for Celtic. Some action at Tynecastle. Pat, we'll just go to that first. Alan Preston watching Hart St. Johnston.
There's a penalty kick to St. Johnston. Liam Craig will take it. He's left-footed. Referee's blowing the whistle. He comes up. Jack Harrell's in the goal. Craig hits it. Into the back of the net. St. Johnston 1-0. Liam Craig.
1-3-0 there on their last visit. St. Johnston as Celtic come forward. It's Armstrong's ball in. Looking for Chris Dames. Too high for him. Then hoisted clear there by Marvin Johnson at the penalty spot up towards McDonald. And to the right-hand side is Cadden. Short ball infield to Margaro Gomez, who is on loan from Hearts. Be interesting to see if he's going to be part of Robbie Nielsen's plans at Tynecastle next season, as it's moved infield by Celtic. Motherwell losing possession out of their right flank. Celtic have their back going left to right, as they tend to do in the first half of games here at Celtic Park. We've played almost 9.5 goalless minutes between Celtic and the only side to beat them here in the league this season, Motherwell.
Yes. The last games, Celtic dominated in possession, dominated most of the early play. Motherwell have been very tentative, actually, in the way that they've sort of got about closing Celtic down, and Armstrong particularly on that sort of left-hand side, really energetic, good chance he created, and he's had a good run a little minute ago also down that left-hand side. So Celtic starting off really well.
Ryan Christie started off well as two, because he's playing in that centre-forward role, which isn't his primary position, but he's showed some good touches already. Another one there, just didn't quite fall for him in the second touch to get him in and goal, but he certainly started well playing in that number 9 role.
Yeah, and when he plays up front, he'll have to keep on the move and create problems that way. He's not going to be the one that's going to get in, I don't think, of crosses, just thrown in from the wide areas. He's not the biggest guy in the world, but his movement, and that's what he's got to do in this game, and that changing of maybe with Tom Rogic also, and then sort of kind of getting involved in that sort of passing, what Celtic do very, very well in the last third.
One ball by the Motherwell skipper McManus into the Celtic box, where it is chested back to his goalkeeper by Sviatchenko. And Gordon bowls it again to Tierney, and he plays it across his own penalty area now with Stefan Johansson, who's moving up towards the halfway line here. Low ball with the left foot out to Lustig, first time down the right hand side for Roberts. Good sliding challenge by Johnson. They came off Roberts after the tackle, so it's out to the Motherwell ball. Marvin Johnson started not too bad here on this near side, and it'll be well to keep Patrick Roberts quiet for 90 minutes. If indeed he lasts the 90 minutes, he was exceptional when he took his goals against Aberdeen last week. It faded as the game went on, but he's more than capable. The £12 million man on loan from Manchester City.
He is, of course, he is. Marvin Johnson, he's got pace, Marvin Johnson, as we know, huge pace, but he's not a natural defender, so it's going to be, he'll have to stand up, he'll get, have to get a little bit of help over this side, especially when Roberts gets the ball and he's in a 1v1 situation.
McGregor to Johansson in the centre circle, turns it out to his near side for Roberts. The overlap comes from Lustig. Roberts uses that as a decoy to the angle of the box, plays it back to Johansson, takes a touch then, hits it with a left foot and drags it wide off Conor Ripley's post there, the right hand post that Johansson looked at the goal, and it will be a goal kick to the steel men. We played 12 minutes, Celtic 0, Motherwell 0, more action at Tynecastle for Alan Preston to tell us about.
And it's 2-0 to the wayside. There's a great ball, there's a corner from Danny Swanson right in the 6-yard box, and there's Graham coming from about 4 yards out, knocking out the back of the net. Great start for St Johnson, going for 5 in a row. That's now St Johnson 2.
Oh, isn't it just 2-0, 3-0 on their last visit? They're already 2-0 up inside 12 minutes or so at Tynecastle if they're on time with us, but that's 2-0 to St Johnston, who are ending the season superbly well, as they did last season as well. Another fourth place finish for them. Motherwell will finish fifth no matter what, of course, as Johansson plays it to Lustig on this near side. It's forward to Johansson. Motherwell cannot get into this game at all. It's all about Celtic right now. As it comes to Rogic, shrugs off Gomez, pokes it through towards Christie. Too much on it though, and it's right through to Conor Ripley.
Yeah. Motherwell's caught a little bit in whether they should press the sort of the, especially the Celtic defenders, to kind of lay it off them and allowing Celtic to build the game. And they're very comfortable when Celtic can do that. You know, they knock the ball about well, they pick out the guys in between the lines then, and that creates problems for Motherwell. So they're kind of caught in between whether to press high and quickly or drop and consolidate.
Johansson here for Celtic into the centre circle. It's Roberts who uses the outside of the left foot to find Roberts. Now he's got the overlapping run from Lustig. First time cross ball into the box is tossed clear by Pearson. Back it comes to Rogic. It's over the bar by Ripley. Wonderful hit there by Tom Rogic. Took a touch and then lashed it with the left foot. Ripley was equal to it, as he was time and time again at Fir Park last month. It's at the expense of another Celtic corner.
Yeah, this time you've got to just applaud the ability of Rogic, taking it on his chest, getting up in the air, hitting it first time on the volley into the top corner. Ripley making a decent save.
Second corner of the game for Celtic, 14 in, and it comes, it's headed down off the post. Was it there? Lustig as a man in the line. They're claiming handball, I think they are. It is behind only for a corner. There was someone on the line and on the far post as that corner kick came in.
Yeah, Motherwell just hanging on here. You know, they're getting absolutely pummeled, and that was a free header from Lustig. I think it was Gomez who was on the post, and you know, we couldn't see from here, but it could have been a handball. They claimed for it.
Corner on the other side, North Stand side, tucked in by Armstrong. The keeper comes, gets something onto it. It wasn't conclusive. He's fortunate that it dropped a Motherwell man, and that is Pearson, who has slid the ball out to Chris Cadden on this near side. He's driving down the left flank, he's deep inside Celtic territory. Good tackle there by McGregor, but it's time for Motherwell's first corner of the afternoon. That was an excellent counter-attacking move. Pearson out to Cadden.
Yeah, brilliant run actually from Cadden, all the full length of the pitch from almost the edge of Celtic's box and end up in a corner, but young McGregor stuck to his task and getting his tackle in, but good strength and running power from Chris Cadden.
Lionel Ainsworth's going to take it on this near side, and it's going to be right-footed here as they attack the west end of Celtic Park. Short into the box for McDonald, knocks it back to Johnson on the line, but he's in that pinch rubber by Armstrong, who's driving forward. He's got Roberts to his right and Christie to his left. Plays it out to Christie, not a great first touch there. Christie will get it back as his initial pass ricochets back to him. It's out to Roberts on this near side. There's an offside flag, and that ends all thoughts of a Celtic counter-attack and a Celtic opening goal there. 15 minutes in, Celtic 0, Motherwell 0 at Pittodrie, Aberdeen 0, Ross County 0, and at Tynecastle, Hearts 0, St Johnston 2. It's Craig and Cummins on the score sheet again for the Saints.
It is a big chance here for Celtic, actually, in the counter-attack. It was a corner kick, I think it was off the training ground from Motherwell. Didn't quite happen. Johnson giving the ball away in the edge of Celtic's box, and then Celtic just broke it. Only for a bad touch from young Ryan Christie, I think Celtic was almost 4v2 situation.
Ryan Shearer, the pitch is bathing in spring sunshine as the long ball comes through again. There's a flag, this time it's against Motherwell, and Celtic have a free kick deep inside their own half. 16 minutes in here as Johansson takes it back to Gordon. No goals as yet here. Long from Gordon out to that left hand side towards Tierney, is headed behind by Cadden for a Celtic throw. Now they are just the four league defeats. They did lose their last one against St Johnston, who, as I mentioned, had a wonderful run post-split towards the end of the campaign, racking up the victories. Aberdeen and Celtic both put to the sword, and it looks like they're going to do the Tynecastle double over Hearts this afternoon. Certainly things continue that way in the capital as Roberts gets it from Lustig. South foot, left foot pass through towards Christie's, cut out there by Ben Hall, the Northern Irishman, and now it's out here with Johnson, who plays it off Roberts, and it's out for a Motherwell throw-in, level with their own 18-yard line. Maybe just a bit further forward than that by the time Marvin Johnson takes this. Steelmen seeing a little bit more of the ball. It's a tortuous start for the campaign. A couple of wins in their first 10 matches. It, of course, cost Ian Barraclough his job as Motherwell manager. That run, coupled with the fact that they lost in the League Cup after extra time to Greenock Morton. Cadden chasing down the right hand side and fouling Kieran Tierney. They try to wrestle possession back to the visitors. It's a Celtic free kick, about level with their own penalty spot, and the goalkeeper's going to take this. Nothing each.
Yeah, the positive thing for Mark McGee is that they're still 0-0. They've been absolutely hammered in that first 17, 18 minutes, and surprising that Celtic hasn't put the ball in the back of the net. So that's a positive for Mark, and then if they can settle themselves down and try to just keep themselves in this game, they will get the chance, there's no question about that.
We're going to go back to Tynecastle and Alan Preston. Alan, it's all happening in the capital.
It's not an end of season game here. The brilliant stuff. Hats are back in the match. It's a ball up for Bafford. Headed up in the air by Scobie. And there's a looping header from Arnold Juman in the top corner. Hats are back in it. Hearts 1, St Johnstone 2.